Got it. Good evening. Welcome to worship on this cold night. We're going to start with a song by, I think it's Who You Say I Am. So welcome to worship on this Wednesday night. Tonight we're going back to what we did before Lent, and so we're working on the catechism and commandment number 6 tonight. So we're glad you're here to join us in worship. Please join me in the confession and the forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose voice is upon the waters, whose mercy is poured out upon all people, and whose goodness cascades over all creation. Amen. And let us confess our sin, trusting in the abundant grace of God. Holy God, you search us and know us. You are acquainted with all our ways. We confess that our hearts are burdened by sin, our own sins, and the broken systems that bind us. We turn inward, failing to follow your outward way of love. We distrust those who are not like us. We exploit the earth and its resources and fail to consider generations to come. Forgive us, gracious God. for all we have done and left undone. Even before the words are on our tongues, you know them. Receive them in your divine mercy. Amen. How vast is God's grace! Through the power and the promise of Jesus Christ, our sins are washed away, and we are claimed as God's own beloved. Indeed, we are forgiven. In the wake of God's forgiveness, we are called to be the beloved community, living out Christ's justice and the Spirit's reconciling peace. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So we're going to do Psalm 133 as our opening today. So will you join me? How good and how pleasant it is when kindred live together in unity. Flowing down upon the beard of Aaron, flowing down upon the collar of his robe. It's like the dew of Hemron, flowing down upon the hill of Zion. For there the Lord has commanded the blessing, life forevermore. So our first reading comes from Exodus chapter 12, verse 14, and this is the sixth commandment: you shall not commit adultery. Please join me in the prayer of the day. Almighty God, with joy we celebrate the day of our Lord's resurrection. By the grace of Christ among us, enable us to show the power of the resurrection in all that we say and do. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So our first reading comes from Malachi chapter 2, beginning at verse 13. And this you will do as well. You cover the Lord's altar with tears, with weeping and groaning, because he no longer regards the offering or accepts it with favor at your hand. You ask, why does he not? Because the Lord, as a witness between you and the wife of your youth, to whom you have been faithful, though she is your companion and your wife by covenant, did not one God make her? Both flesh and spirit are his. And what does the one God desire? Godly offspring? So look to yourselves and do not let anyone be faithless to the wife of his youth. And then from Ephesians chapter 5, beginning at verse 22. Wives, be subject to your husbands as you are to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, the body of which he is the Savior. Just as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives, not just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her in order to make her holy, by cleansing her with the washing of water by the word, so as to present the church to himself in splendor, without a spot or a wrinkle or anything of the kind. Yes, so that she may be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hates his own body, but he nourishes it and tenderly cares for it, just as Christ does for the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I am applying it to Christ and the church. Words of our Lord. This is a really, really hard text to try and decipher. And so I'm going to go a little bit further. Martin Luther calls the sixth commandment, you shall not commit adultery. And he says, we are to fear and love God so that we are pure and decent in our lives, in word and deed, And each of us loves and honors his or her spouse. So how do we love and respect each other? These are just a few things I came up this afternoon with when I was thinking about it. So one is to listen to each other and hear what each other has to say. Another would be to learn to care for each other, finding what makes your spouse very special to you. To learn what each other likes, and then to show respect by doing things that help to make things better for the other. Be kind to each other. Do things that are respectful. Speak well of each other. In this book on our roots and faith, Martin Luther says that the first few commandments are how we expect or are expected to treat God, but the middle is commandments that help us in our relationships with other people. Each of them, God protects and gives us something essential. So in the sixth commandment, God protects what is nearest and dearest in our life, namely our companionship. Above all, he wants us to give our companions their whole being, everything that we can to share with them, a husband or a wife, because sin and the devil attack this companionship with such terrible force. God says a loud and resounding no to anything that disrupts our companionship in our marriage. And I think that's an important thing for us to remember, is that every single day of our lives, the devil is trying to separate us from God with whatever we do. The devil is there. And when we allow things to happen to each other instead of respecting each other and showing each other love, that's when our marriages fall apart. So it happens in many small and little ways, and it happens in many big ways. And there's always people that are there to listen and counsel with, but there are some times when things happen that you just can't go back, no matter how hard it is. And I think one of the biggest things that gets in the way is chemical use, whether it's alcohol or drugs or whatever you put as something important to you. If you don't respect each other and you don't care for each other, the marriage will fall apart. And I sometimes think that money is another thing that happens. Yes, chemicals are huge, but a lot of us tend to take money as a chemical, and they don't share it with your spouse. If you don't nurture your relationship every single day, it falls apart. So in what way do you show respect and love and care for each other? What's important for you? Visiting with them? A hug? Maybe sharing a meal. It's those conversations. It's the whole piece that goes into a relationship. And if you don't do it, if you don't nurture it, if you don't respect it, if you don't care for it, it'll fall apart. Okay. That's our catechism connection for tonight. in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So our prayers for tonight, alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. You shower your church with grace, O God. Unite the whole church on earth so that with one heart it testifies to the resurrection of Jesus Christ with power and love. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Whoops, I got it wrong up there. You proclaim the blessings of life forevermore, like dew upon the waters. Refresh your creation, restore waters, cleanse the air, and provide revitalizing moisture to parched land. Give your whole creation the promise of new life. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. You direct nations, O God, guide all authority, that they shepherd their people in the way of your love. Defeat in us our impulse to war. Bestow the peace of Christ upon those in authority and breathe upon them the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. You place upon us, the heart of your church, a spirit of sharing. Give us the power of your generous spirit that we provide for the needs of others. Specifically, we remember Larry Parker, Tessa Teogus, Sharon Trulock, Darla Willie, Peggy Schley, Bernice Steffen, Leslie Sagadahl, Alan Palmer, Cindy Peterson, Myra Dahlman, Glenn Bach, Judy Tindelin, Julie Brocky. And then we also remember the family of Amber Botcher. Announce their peace to those who are lonely, hurting, suffering, or afraid. Let us pray. You share the gift of eternal life. In thanksgiving and in remembrance, we recall the lives and the gifts of those who live in endless joy. Today, we celebrate with Brinley Goberish as she was baptized on Sunday or Saturday. And we also pray for the babies that are going to be baptized yet. Kaysen Schmidt, Maddox Schmidt, Harlow Schmidt, Michael Wesley Anderson, and Wade Joseph Torkey. Let us pray. You share the gift of eternal life. Unite with us and all who are sharing in the resurrection of hope, in the hope of new life in Christ. We raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So our offering, as usual, is in the back. Will you join me in this offering prayer? O God, receive these gifts as you receive us, like a mother receives her child with arms open wide. Nourish us anew in your tender care and empower us in the faithful service to tend to others with the same love. Through Jesus Christ, our saving grace. Amen. In the night, If you don't have your communion, we'll ask you to get that now and remove the cellophane on the top to get the wafer and then the foil in order to open up to the wine. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is the new covenant in my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you eat this bread and drink this wine. Do it in remembrance of me." Will you join me in the prayer our Lord taught us to pray? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now the body of Christ is given for you, and the blood of Christ is shed for you. And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and give you peace. Amen. And our evening blessing. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, watch over us all. Amen. We give thanks to you, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously protected us today. We ask you to forgive us all of our sins, where we have done wrong, and graciously to protect us tonight. Into your hands we commend ourselves, and let your holy angel be with us so that the wicked foe may have no power over us. Amen. And now, God, the Creator, strengthen you. Jesus, the Beloved, fill you. And the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, keep you in peace. Amen. Go in peace and share the good news. Thanks be to God. There we go.